Shampoos are supposed to clean your hair, right? The thing is, some products marketed as shampoos and cleansers contain very little cleansing ingredients or even none at all. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the ingredients that actually make your shampoo cleansing. Hello everyone, Kayla here, and this is What the Kink, a natural hair channel. So, the ingredients that I want to talk about today are called surfactants. And you may wonder, what is a surfactant? Literally, surfactant means something that acts on the surface. And surfactants can do different things. They can act on the surface to make it easier for you to detangle your hair. They can act on the surface to make it to where your hair is less frizzy. And they can also act on the surface to bind to dirt and remove dirt from your hair in the act of cleansing your hair. So the specific surfactants that we're going to talk about in today's video are the actual cleansing surfactants and not the ones that condition and defrizz and all of that kind of stuff. There are two types of cleansing surfactants found in your favorite shampoo or cleanser. That will be sulfate cleansers and non-sulfate cleansers. Sulfate cleansers are pretty easy to spot in your ingredients because they usually start with the name like ammonium or sodium, and then the middle will say laurel, laureth, cocoyl, and then the end will end with sulfate. Okay, so sodium lauryl sulfate is a sulfate cleanser. The non-sulfate cleansers are a little bit more difficult to spot. They will usually start with something like sodium or ammonium. They will also be in the middle of laurel, laureth, cocoyl, but the ending will be something different, like isothionate, sulfonate, glutamate. So this extra eight that is being added on there instead of sulfate, it's tumate and that those kind of things. So they're very similar in their wording to the sulfate cleansers. And then there are some non-sulfate cleansers that don't have this naming scheme at all. What comes to mind first and foremost is coconut or propyl betaine. I absolutely love coconut or propyl betaine. When I first brought cleansing back into my regimen, that just sounds so nasty. That was the number one ingredient that I looked for in a sulfate-free cleanser because I knew that it would actually clean my hair. Coconut or propyl betaine is that girl. It will clean your hair. Other popular things, there are cleansers that have names that are similar to coconut or propyl betaine. And then there's another one called diesel glucoside. This is really, really popular in Shea Moisture shampoos. They really like to use Miss Diesel glucoside. Of course, this is not an exhaustive list. These rules won't help you identify every single cleanser in your ingredients list. So I will give you a link, okay? Go to curlsbot.com/cleansers. I will link that in the description box, and this page has a crazy long list of both sulfate and non-sulfate cleansers if you really want to get the actual full names and you're not just going to go and use the rules that I use to identify cleansers in my products. So let's actually examine the ingredients in a couple of shampoos that you may or may not have heard of. The first one I want to do is Sola Toscana shampoo. The reason I'm using this is because it is a shampoo that I actually really like and I enjoyed using. And it is a top tier shampoo. You're going to pay some money for it. So I have it open up here and I'm going to look at the ingredients because I don't have a bottle on hand at the moment. We're going to look at the first five ingredients, okay? So we got water. We got aloe vera leaf extract, which honestly, extracts might as well be good as adding tea to the water, honestly, to me. So let's put that finger back down. That ain't ingredient number two in my mind. Next, we have Imodium lauryl sulfate. That's a sulfate cleanser we talked about earlier. Glycerin. Cocoa glucoside. That's another cleanser. And then we have a olive fruit extract. Again, I don't care about extracts, so we're moving on. Wheat germ oil. And that's the first five ingredients. So as you can see, there are cleansers in the top five ingredients, two cleansers to be exact, a sulfate cleanser and a non-sulfate cleanser that is a little bit more gentle. That shampoo is very cleansing and it defines my curls and everything. Just want to throw that out here. All right. So the next shampoo that we're going to look at, or rather the next cleanser we're going to look at, is the Hydra Curl Former Aqua Curl Cleanser. I didn't have the online version of the ingredients, but girl, I haven't filled my empties yet. So I had a bottle. How convenient. This bottle is throwing out all the lighting, but I have to hold it up for the first five. So we got water, cedarol alcohol, Behentrium ammonium chloride, lauryl metoprolyl betaine, that's a cleanser, And then we have hydroxypropyl starch phosphate. That's ingredient number 5. So they don't waste no time with no extracts or anything like that, ma'am. Everything is straight ingredients. The only thing about this is that, did you notice that I didn't get to the cleanser until ingredient number 4, and at that it was a more gentle cleanser. So this is a shampoo that you're going to use more so if you're someone who, maybe you're someone who doesn't really like to use shampoo. Pick this up. Maybe you're someone who likes to, in the middle of the week, co-wash type situation or refresh your hair in the middle of the week. This is going to be the shampoo for you. This is not something you put on hair like this. This is day one hair. I don't do like your faves and soften my hair up and come back after day 3 or 4. Nah, this is hair that I just did, and it has a gel cast on it that will break off in the next couple of days. But the products that I use on my hair reactivate with water. So even on day 7, when this is crusty, when I put water on this, it's going to be reactivated and my hair is going to be weighed down and heavy again, and I need something to shampoo it out. This is not what you use when you're trying to do that. All right, moving on. The next cleanser that I want to do is As I Am Co-Wash. I picked this one because it's extremely popular. Everyone loves it. I've tried it several times and I absolutely hate it. And I think it's because I have a really greasy scalp. We don't talk about folks with natural hair that have greasy, nasty scalps. But I am that girl, y'all. My scalp is nasty, so I have to keep it clean. 7 days and we're back to grease and grime on my scalp. No products added on it. So anyway, here are the first 5 ingredients of everyone's beloved co-wash. Water, cedar alcohol, citronium chloride, cedar alcohol, coconut oil. A lot of things that provide slip. So you could probably detangle the heck out of your hair with this product for sure. But please note that in the first 5 ingredients, did you hear me say anything that sounded like a cleanser from the beginning of this video? I didn't. There's nothing in the first 5 ingredients of this product that is going to actually clean your hair. And I don't think they advertise it as a cleanser. Yeah, because it says use as needed on an intermittent basis with cleansing pudding, sulfate free moisturizing cleanser. So they're telling you on the product page to use their cleanser, which I haven't had a chance to look at the cleansing pudding or whatever, but they're basically telling you that. Like, as use this as like a in-between conditioning cream. It says light, no suds conditioning cream. They're telling you it's not a cleanser. But anyway, moving on from that one, I got the last one. The last one is the Camille Rose Cleansing Milk Collection. There are several of them. I actually thought this collection was super cute because they are, first of all, the word cleansing milk is cute. And then all of them, I do believe, are vegan as well, which is really, really cute. Because I believe the owner of Camille Rose is vegan, but the products tend to have, some of them do have animal-derived ingredients, and the products are not all vegan. You have to check the ingredients. So first 5 of the, which one did I pick? I picked the Rose Cleansing Milk. This just sounds like something cute to have on the corner of your bathroom. Just, oh, here's my Rose Cleansing Milk. I don't know. But anyway, so water, rose flower extract. I'm not counting no extract as an ingredient. We have linseed oil, which is flaxseed oil. Guar, glycerin, and then we have sunflower seed oil. Note here that I did not mention anything in the first 5 of this that is cleansing. None of those are the cleansing type of surfactants at all. So again, you know, I don't really know how she's marketing this one because she has less product information on her pages than As I Am, but yeah, it says a moisturizing hair cleansing milk crafted to promote shiny, beautiful hair. But even she's just restating the name of the product. She's not telling you that it's going to clean your hair, right? So there is nothing in the top 5 ingredients of this that would clean your hair. Now you may be wondering, well, Kayla, why does this matter? Why, you know, what can I do with this information? What you can do for this information, with this information, is you can look on the ingredients list of your favorite cleansers or whatever, or maybe even cleansers you haven't tried yet. Look on the ingredients list. Look at how many of these cleansing ingredients there are. Is it a harsher or stronger cleansing agent? How far up on the ingredients list is it? Is it in the top 5? The more cleansers there are, the stronger of the cleansers, the higher up on the ingredients list the cleansers are, the more stripping, the more cleansing of a shampoo it is. And then take into account your lifestyle and how you like to wear your hair. I know for me, I need a shampoo that has more cleansing ingredients. They need to be higher up on the ingredients list because I wear my hair in a very super defined wash and go, and that includes gel. You know what I'm saying? That includes leave-in. I know how I wear my hair, so I need my hair to be more cleansed than maybe someone who maybe does a cream-styled hair. Maybe they put cream on their hair and do twist in a twist-out or something like that. Maybe they're not very heavy-handed with product. That person is not going to need to use as strong of a cleanser as I would need to use. Just kind of like for you people to sprinkle it on to help you out. Next week, I'm going to be releasing a video in which I'm going to cover some of my favorite cleansers that I like to use in different categories. So we're going to do clarifying all the way down to more gentle cleansing shampoos. So please stick around and stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, there's some videos over here you can check out. You can tap the subscribe button down below. I release videos every single week, and I will talk to you in the next one.